Hey, I'm Wojciech. I'm excited to introduce Enso, a completely new way to build software. Enso has a variety of applications, especially in the realm of data science. It is used to build credit risk scoring models, to connect and supervise thousands of smart devices, and even to research new ways of genome editing. And all of these things can be done in Enso without writing a single line of code, and in a fraction of time that it would take you today. You know, there is something inherently broken with the way we build software nowadays. You are forced to build and maintain a complex memory model of how the machine is processing data, which leaves a little room for your creativity. You bury yourself in code and become alienated from the actual problems you are trying to solve. We believe that processing data and creating software in general should be an interactive task that should take minutes, not weeks. And that's why we have created Enso. Enso is an easy-to-use collaborative canvas that allows you to build data-driven applications simply by connecting visual components together. It automatically analyzes the data, predicts your intentions, and suggests possible next steps. It has a high-performance data processing engine and can visualize even millions of data points in real time. Also, it's open source and completely free to use. In the next few minutes, we will use Enso to connect to one of the Los Angeles open datasets to learn which advertiser has the most advertisements across all the bus stops in the city. Then we will display their location on an interactive city map. Let's get started. First, we are going to visit the Los Angeles Open Data website to copy the API URL. Now, let's open Enso. As the first step, let's query for the data. To create a new component, I'm pressing the Tab key, which opens an interactive search box that also displays useful documentation and examples right alongside your search. Now, we want to download something from an HTTP endpoint, so I'll type HTTP here. And yeah, here we go. This component simply allows me to connect to a web data source, so let's use it. I'm pasting the URL that I copied before, and I'm pressing enter. And that's it. I've just connected to a public API. Each component in Enso is able to visualize its results. I can hover my mouse over its output port to take a quick look. Enso lets me know that the result is a text. It looks like it's a JSON, so let's try and parse it. Let's search for JSON-related components. We have one called toJSON, which is probably what we are looking for. As soon as I connect these two components together, Enso will recompute the values and will allow us to explore the results visually. Let's inspect the value of this component. We can see that the data contains a lot of information, including the name of the advertiser for a given bus stop. JSON, however, is not the nicest format to work with. I'd much prefer to work with a tabular data, so let's convert it to a table. As soon as I press the Tab key, Enso will automatically analyze the data flow and provide me with hints highly tailored to my use case. Let's search for table then, and yeah, here it is. I'm going to take a look at the advertiser names and pick one at random for now. Jerry Goose, yeah, that sounds perfect. I'd love to see all of the advertising locations on a map. First, I'm going to filter the data. I'm pressing the Tab key again to find a component that would allow me to do exactly that. And here it is, it's called add. According to the documentation, it takes an expression to be applied to the table. So let's filter out all the advertisers except Jerry. And yep, perfect. We can now open the visualization to check if the data is correct. We can also switch the visualization to, for example, a map and see all of the locations of Jerry's ads. One of the most powerful features of Enso is how easy it is to automate the data pipeline. For example, I would love to create a process which can automatically select the advertiser with the most locations for me. To do this, we want to group the table by advertiser and count the number of ads they have. As before, I'm pressing the Tab key to find something which would allow me to group the table by the advertiser name. And yeah, here we go. The column name was advertiser, so let's group by it. It seems like it worked. Now let's count how many ads each advertiser has. Let's just look for the count component. It couldn't be simpler, right? Having that in place, let's sort the advertisers in a descending order. Let's place two components, sort and reverse. Okay, amazing. Now let's extract the names of the advertisers in their new order, and then let's select the one who has buffed the most of ads. First, we'll extract the index column, and we'll take the first value. And it seems that our most popular advertiser is Mom LA. Congratulations, Mom! We can now simply plug in our results to the node we have created at the beginning. The map will automatically display only the ads of the most popular advertiser, so exactly what we are looking for. Please keep in mind that what you have seen is ENSO 2.0 alpha preview. It lacks interactive widgets on nodes and many other things that I'm sure will wow you in the coming months. So this is incredible. I mean, in just a few minutes we were able to connect and download data from a public API, count the number of ads per advertiser, select the one who has bought most, and display all of his ads on an interactive map. All inside ENSO. And ENSO comes with hundreds of built-in components that allows you to read and write files, process and analyze images, perform both in-memory and SQL analytics, control other applications, and even control external IoT devices. But the part that sets ENSO miles apart from other data science tools is the ENSO engine. The ENSO engine makes ENSO extremely powerful, just as powerful as a programming language. Truth to be told, ENSO is a very unique programming language with two interchangeable representations. ENSO is not just this nice-looking interface. Every time you add or connect nodes, it generates ENSO code under the hood. Every time you modify the code, the graph is updated as well. But that's not all. ENSO is a fully polyglot language. This means that you can import libraries from Java, JavaScript, Python, and R and use them without creating any wrappers and with close to zero runtime performance overhead. Soon, it will also support other languages like C++, Rust, Ruby, or Scala. This makes ENSO extremely extendable. For example, would you like to build Google TensorFlow models in an interactive, visual way? I would love to. However, you don't have to wait for us to deliver that. You can do it by yourself or you can get our community involved. Also, our visualization engine is extendable as well. You can just plug in any JavaScript visualization or you can utilize our high-performance WebGL-based renderer, allowing you to display even millions of data points, 60 frames per second, on a laptop. Join our community at discord.gg/enso and let's have a chat about your use cases and the future of data processing. We can't wait to see all the amazing things you will build with ENSO, and you can download it at enso.org. It's open source, free to use, and available for Mac, Windows, and Linux.